privileges, rights, and obligations that come along with citizenship. To start the formal portion of our ceremony, please rise for the national anthem as sung by Harding students Alan Moore and Sunny Payne.
Citizenship exam. I praise you with respect, because you are here receiving your naturalization certificate and sworn your oath to this country. Each of you are uniquely valuable to our country. You bring new ideas, good working ethic, and the cultural richness to our society. I have faith in you, as early Americans have faith in me. May your children grow well in this land. May you find a good job, get a high promotion, and may your business continue to grow and bring forth economic success. And may you retire well with the quality of life that you worked so hard for. We will stand together as proud Americans now and into the future to make this country even greater and more prosperous. Keep your arms open to all people and help those who are less fortunate, regardless of their background. Now that you are a citizen of this country, do not take your right to vote for granted. Go to the poll, exercise your right to vote. And if you have opportunity today or tomorrow, do register first. And I'm glad that we are in a state where you can do the same day registration. So do participate in election, including running for office yourself. That's my advice for you today. Lastly, when you have time or when you need help, do come see me at the state capitol. For it is your capital too. It's the people's house. I will be there to greet you. Until then, take care. Take care of yourself. Have a good health. And God bless you, and God bless America.
Brazil, Canada, Guyana, Jamaica, Laos, Nigeria, Republic of Korea, United Kingdom, Sri Lanka, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Burma, El Salvador, India, Japan, Liberia, the Philippines, Sudan, Cambodia, Ethiopia, Iraq, Kenya, Mexico, Russia, Somalia, and Vietnam. At this time, I'd like to call upon Citizenship and Immigration Officer Luis Borja for the purpose of making the necessary motions. Officer Borja.
Thank you, Your Honor. If it pleases the court, the government recommends the oath of allegiance be administered to 48 applicants for naturalization who have been interviewed and whose applications have been approved. They are permanent residents of the United States and have resided within the Minneapolis-St. Paul, Minnesota district for the required 3-month period. They are persons of good moral character who are attached to the principles of the Constitution and form of government of the United States. The government recommends that the court administer the oath of allegiance as required by the law so that the applicants may be admitted to citizenship and that the name changes requested in the petitions be granted.
Having heard the motion, it is indeed my pleasure to say the motions are granted. At this time, I'll administer the oath of allegiance. Will the applicants please rise, raise your right hands, and repeat after me. I solemnly swear that I will support and defend Constitution and laws of the United States of America against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I give up and surrender any allegiance to any king, queen or prince, or to any state or country which I have held up until this day, That as a citizen of the United States, I will, when lawfully directed, bear arms and perform non-combatant service in the armed forces of the United States. Or I will, when directed, perform non-military service on behalf of the United States. I take these obligations freely, without any purpose of evasion, and declare today I am a citizen of the United States of America. So help me God. Congratulations. Tirelessly working to achieve U.S. citizenship, because it's your efforts and achievements which serve to remind me and all natural-born citizens of this country just how fortunate we all should feel in being an American. For the vast overwhelming majority of our nation's population, citizenship comes easily simply by virtue of having been born here. And perhaps because of that, not having ever lived under any other form of government in our lifetime, we may sometimes take the privileges and liberties of U.S. citizenship a little bit for granted. Your achievements today serve to remind all of us that we should not and cannot take our special status as citizens of this country for granted. Because, with the exception of Native Americans who are indigenous to this continent, the history of every American family starts with someone who first had the desire, the determination, and the courage to immigrate to this country in search of the liberties and opportunities which are its promise. It is thus up to each of us who are already citizens, just as it will be up to your future descendants, to give honor to those who have come before us by how we live our lives and serve our neighbors and communities as we exercise the rights bestowed upon each of us as citizens of this nation. By your achievements today, you have earned the rights and liberties that go with being an American citizen. But along with those rights and liberties come important obligations as well. Our nation's Constitution begins with the phrase, quote, "We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union," close quote. I believe that these 15 words alone are at the heart of what it means to be and what our responsibilities are as citizens of these United States. We the people. From out of these words, a community has worked and continues to work together to build a nation of laws, not of a dictator. A nation where the governed themselves govern through the use of a ballot rather than through the use of a bullet. A nation where no one is above the law and where disputes among neighbors are resolved and public safety is maintained peaceably and with due process of law through public trials, conducted before a jury of one's peers. A nation where each of us contribute to the fabric of our society, each in our own individual way, but each for the common and collective purpose as also set forth in the Constitution, quote, to establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity. Close quote. In order to form a more perfect union. These words reflect and recognize that the promise and potential of these United States has been, but remains, a work in progress, to which we must all fully dedicate ourselves in our ongoing labor. The history of our nation so far is one made up of a great many wondrous achievements, to be sure, but also it contains instances when we as a nation have failed to live up to the spirit and promise of the Declaration of Independence as found in the words, quote, We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." Close quote. But even throughout the sadder parts of our nation's history, the millions of citizens who have come before us have suffered, strived, persevered, and worked ceaselessly not only to maintain the good that had been achieved, but more importantly, to correct then-present failings and to work to improve and reform our nation into yet a more perfect union, where everyone, regardless of race, gender, religion, orientation, ethnicity, country of origin, or economic status, will realize equal justice and therefore equal opportunity under law. This important collective work does and must continue, and this work requires from all citizens of the United States, which now includes each of you, that they constantly seek to become informed and knowledgeable about the facts, and not just the rhetoric, that underscore the public policy and political debates of the time. And in doing so, make up their own minds on where they stand on the topics, while yet keeping an open mind and engaging in a peaceful and respectful dialogue with those of their neighbors who may be of a different view than their own, but who also equally love their country. That they work to be tolerant and respectful of the rich variety that is evident among all the people of this great nation. That they work to resist efforts to see diversity as something to be feared, but rather that they strive to see it as a strength and resource of this country that is just yet waiting to be even more fully tapped. That they follow the law, but be willing to seek to peaceably change the law if they believe that it needs changing. That they strive to give some of their time in the service of others, to be engaged members of their community, state, and nation by volunteering, helping their neighbors in times of need, and gladly performing jury service when called upon. That they do not seek to avoid paying their taxes, which are collected for use in support of the greater good and common welfare, being ever mindful that there are yet millions around the world who would gladly do so if only they too could someday stand where you stand and publicly declare their own oath of allegiance to this nation. That they seek out public office on any level if they have a desire to do so. That they should willingly answer the nation's call whenever it may come, whether in times of war or peace. But most importantly, that they should vote. The exercise of the right to elect one's local, state, and national leaders is the single most important obligation of every citizen. Here in Minnesota, our neighbors demonstrate that they understand this solemn obligation when they routinely lead the nation in the level of voter turnout, general election after general election. By your oath of allegiance today, you now belong to a partnership of equals. You are now among those encompassed within the phrase, "We the People." And I trust and know that each of you will fully do your part to help with the ever ongoing work and effort to even yet form a more perfect union. I commend each of you, I applaud you, and I wish all of you every success as you leave here today to take your well-earned and well-deserved place among those who, when asked from where they come, are now able to proudly proclaim, "I am an American."
我就佢咩？我都想到叫佢大攞攞都應啊，俾下佢啊一次 citizenship ceremony 咯嚇啊，呢個
入國號佢
citizenship 嚟 INS 本土嗰個大國，然後咧啊，我上古都在當叫佢啊成透波啊大得 citizenship 啦，亦不過大要抓住下啲，但古大要做到第一世，即係話唔想接第一世啦，我下個古蒙嚟考嗰時古大到第一世，即係話個波庫。 被人民都没有，讲到那肥猪，要拿的是上一赛的被人那肥猪是上一赛被人肥猪嘛，就好像叫 G% 的，被人民有个讲到的 Harding High School 了呢，然后民有猫民有 Association 了呢。 the Jonghai Guadago, just to talk graduate Lu Harding High School, no, the Harding High School, the little bubble, the Jolly Little Tub Jang, the Lute Channel, the number and go to the Lute Jang, the Jong, the Bemo, Dumon Taikan, and no high Jong, Jong, Jai Jong Chow, Joe Beto, Kate Zai Ta, the Dunham Zai Ta, Do, Jang Te, and the Hoyo Bissing Mega, Zinu Rom Hoyo,
So you are American now, you know, because your parents passed the exam. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations, and come back to the east side again. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Where are you from? Russia. All right, good. Welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah. I encourage you, if you ever choose the east side, this is a very friendly place. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah. Congratulations. Congratulations. Where are you from?
Cambodia.
Okay, subsidy. Thank you. 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 Thank you